You alright guys, welcome back to the channel. This video is just about an article I did on strikeengine.com about MAF sensor placement and cold air intakes. Is it important? Is it not? What difference does it make if you put it after a bend? If you want to read the article, link in the description. I'm just going to summarize it in this video. By the end of this video, I think you'll be able to judge the quality of aftermarket cold air intakes from the likes of K&N, InGNS and BAFE, etc. And you'll also be able to choose the optimum MAF sensor placement if you're going to be making a DIY cold air intake. So in the article, I'm going to take you through my story of changing the filter and changing the MAF sensor location on the cold air intake that's on the Octavia VRS project. I'm going to go through the problems I had with the car, the changes that I've made, and the effect that that has had on the engine and the drivability of the engine. So the key takeaways, if I'm going to put this video in a nutshell, the key takeaway is that filter medium seems to have an effect on MAF sensor readings. The location of the MAF sensor before or after a bend can also affect the drivability of a car. So before I get into the data logs, the solutions, the changes that I've made, let's get into the issues that the car was experiencing. The first thing I'm going to mention is the boost control. If you went for a bit of a blast with the car, I mean, you're using the full throttle, and then you will lift off the throttle and want to go at a steady cruise, maybe you're drawing a bit of vacuum immediately after the blast, the car would start to surge badly. And looking at the boost sensor, I could see that the boost pressure was alternating like a switch between 0 and 5 PSI. The other issue was the AFRs in the car were basically rich everywhere. So my first priority was to start making inroads into fixing the AFR problem. I thought ultimately, at the end, either I'm going to be scaling the MAF sensor, I'm going to be tuning the MAF sensor signal, or it's going to be a remap. But before I did any of that, I wanted to make sure that the MAF sensor was reading consistently, because it was pointless of me making changes if under the same circumstances, like X TPS with X RPM, like the MAF sensor is reading different values. And also I wanted to change the Greddy filter for an OEM type paper filter. Personally, I'm not the biggest fan of aftermarket filters like foam filters or cotton type filters, or definitely not metal mesh filters, because I think they let too much dirt through. So the original setup on the car was this. So we've got the MAF sensor here. It's mounted after this 45 degree bend and it's using a Greddy type cone filter. So I've got no issues with Greddy. I had a look at that filter. It seems you can't see daylight through it, put it that way. So it does seem, for a cotton filter, it seems maybe as good as even an Apexi power intake filter. It did seem very good quality. I did some measuring on the dimensions that I've got here, the diameter, and I found a nice size, a nice and big paper cone filter to replace it with. I changed the setup to this, so you can see I've got rid of this bend here, and I've connected the filter directly to the MAF sensor, so it's got a straight shot, a symmetrical shot going into the MAF sensor. I've got this little CFD animation here, so you can see what happens to the air after a bend. And obviously most of the air wants to go to the outside of the bend, and you can see that the turbulence in the pipe lasts for quite a long time after the bend. So let's have a look at the data logs and see what numbers we've got. This is the stock setup with a Greddy filter. This is the bend with a paper filter, and this is the straight shot with a paper filter. And what we're looking for here is for as many cells as possible to be red, and if not red, orange, and then yellow and green. The redder, basically the closer the colors are to the bottom of this rainbow bar here, the better. This indicates that the readings are consistent. We're looking at the standard deviation. Summary of the data logs, there's not a massive difference between the setups. But looking at the amount of reds and oranges in each of the tables, I would say that the paper filter no bend has got more reds and oranges than the Greddy filter.
And with regards to drivability, I think the car is much more stable now. It seemed to be very sensitive on the throttle before, which it's not now. It's very gradual, very progressive with the throttle, which is nice. And before, after a bit of a blast at full throttle, if you'd lift off after, like just to cruise at a steady speed, the car would start to jerk quite badly. And that has stopped now. Well, so far it's stopped. I haven't had that happen with either of the paper filters.
These tests are not blind tests. I did know what intake was on the car when I was doing the testing.
And I did have the idea in my mind that no bend with a paper filter was going to be better than the other setups. So that could be biasing my opinions of the testing, but let's assume that it didn't. And then I was looking at the AFRs at idle. The Greddy average AFR was 12.59 at idle, which is far too rich. But the paper filters had a 14.456 average, a 14.56 average for the bend, and 14.01 with the no bend. Still not 14.7, but definitely better than 12.5.
So all in all, I'd say the conclusion that I've come to from all of that is that it's very important to have a straight shot into the MAF sensor without any bends. And I'd also say that the airflow through the MAF seems to be better with a paper filter over a cone filter. I've got to give it to Turbo Speed, where I took this car for the clutch change. I said to them, what did they think about the 45 degree with the MAF sensor? And they said, yeah, maybe it is, maybe it isn't, but usually it's the type of filter that has the biggest effect. Honestly, I discounted that a little bit because I'd never heard about that. But nevertheless, I was going to change the paper filter anyway. And as I said, with a paper filter, they do seem to be right on that. A paper filter, an OEM type paper filter, does seem to give better flow to a MAF sensor. And as I said, I think the bend is also, getting rid of that bend is also massively helpful. Again, all the logs are on that Strike Engine article. You can see exactly what I'm talking about there. That's it for this video. As always, if you enjoyed it, please vote on it. Please subscribe if you're not a subscriber already. Look after yourselves, and I'll see you again in the next video.